And welcome aboard the Wednesday edition of the Steve Malzberg Show from our New York City studios. Pat Buchanan joins us momentarily, but first let me just catch you up a little bit. Of course, there was a raid overnight, early morning in Paris, an apartment building where they killed two terrorists and arrested several more. Reportedly, they were planning another imminent attack inside of Paris, and there's some discrepancy as to whether or not the mastermind of Friday's attacks, who they've been searching for and who they thought was in Belgium, and that would be Abdelhamid Aboud, whether or not he is one of the two dead terrorists. Again, conflicting reports on that as we take to the air tonight. I will tell you that we have other developments in Honduras. They have detained five Syrians with stolen passports. We also have in Marseille, we have a report of a Jewish teacher being stabbed by ISIS supporters, although the teacher is not facing death from his or her wounds. Nonetheless, the stabbing took place. And we have President Obama in the Philippines attacking, not ISIS, but of course, Republicans. Watch.
When candidates say we want to admit three-year-old orphans, that's political posturing. When individuals say that we should have a religious test and that only Christians, proven Christians, should be admitted, that's offensive and contrary to American values. I cannot think of a more potent recruitment tool for ISIL than some of the rhetoric that's been coming out of here during the course of this debate.
All right, and joining us now, as promised, Patrick J. Buchanan, former GOP presidential candidate, former Nixon and Reagan aide, syndicated columnist. Hello, Pat.
How you doing, Steve?
I'm doing as well as can be expected since we have a president like this. What do you make of what's going on with him?
I don't know what's going on with the president. He was very diffident in that first press conference. He was miffed. He was angry. He was ticked. He didn't really show what he should have shown, which was American leadership in a time of a real crisis for our ally in France. And he really seems to be letting Republican criticism get to him. And I really don't understand it. He's only got a year left, and he ought to stay away from that sort of thing when he's abroad.
Well, absolutely. And I mean, shouldn't his anger be directed at the terrorists and instead of calling that a setback, what they did in Paris?
Well, I think the president has not handled this at all well. There's no question about it, Steve. This was a massacre, a perpetrated massacre, the largest hit on France militarily, lost more casualties than any single incident since World War II. And he's focusing on the Republican Party, and he's calling it a setback in the war on terror. I mean, you have to ask yourself about the mindset of the president right now.
Yeah, well, I couldn't agree with you more. Well, let me ask you about the refugee situation. Governors, candidates, Chuck Schumer today, according to one report, said we might have to take a pause in letting in Syrian refugees. Where do you stand on any more Syrian refugees coming into this country? And what the president says, that it's not who we are, it's un-American, blah, 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 blah.
Look, America has had periods of high immigration and low immigration, and Americans has held off at times bringing in people from countries that are at war or at civil war. Look, I think what the United States needs is a general moratorium on immigration and a halt right now, as I think Rand Paul said, to immigration coming from regions or various countries or sections of countries where real conflict is going on and civil wars are going on and terrorists are operative. It only makes sense. Secondly, we know that the Christians in Syria have been persecuted and attacked and singled out as like the Yazidis have. And if you're going to bring in folks from Syria, you ought to give first priority to those whom you know really cannot survive a victory by ISIS.
So would you be in favor of, because I just want to be clear, of a policy that would let the Syrian Christians in and not the Syrian Muslims at this point?
I think you have to vet everybody coming out of Syria. Frankly, you almost got to vet more closely everybody coming in from everywhere. When you read, Steve, that something like 5,000 passports or something, Syrian passports disappeared in Syria, and that they may be in control of ISIS, for heaven's sakes, I mean, the security of the country comes first.
Yeah, absolutely. I hate to go down to their level, but nonetheless, this is a popular cry. It has been for quite some time with the left. On The View today, they were tearing apart, criticizing Ted Cruz and the Republican candidate, saying it's not very Christian-like to say that they shouldn't allow people in, you know, refugees into the country. And Joy Behar said that Timothy McVeigh was a Christian. In other words, Whoopi said they were bad, dangerous. Actually, she said there are monster Christians like Hitler. Now, Hitler, notwithstanding his birth, he certainly shunned his religion and Christianity as he went on. That's one point. And Timothy McVeigh certainly didn't kill in the name of Jesus Christ. He wasn't a Christian, as far as I know, in his beliefs. So what do you say when you hear nonsense like this? As you know, well, there are bad Christians too.
Well, you know, my feeling is basically that there are people who profess Christianity who have done terrible things, but we are now in a situation where the Islamic world is really in an uproar. It's stirred up. In particular, in Syria, we got terrorists who want to come, who have been in there. They want to come out. They want to come to the West. They've attacked in Beirut. They blew up an airliner. They blew up that situation in Paris. And they ought to be, these people really should be singled out and kept out. And any kind of vetting should take a long time. And quite frankly, my view, Steve, has always been, look, why do we need right now many more immigrants in this country right now and taking this kind of risk to bring them in?
Right. So is it fair to say that you would say pending vetting and, you know, and maybe even not right now, that all Muslims, there should be no immigration, no Muslims allowed into the United States? Is that what you're saying?
Well, I would say right now, if I were president of the United States, I would have declared a moratorium on all immigration to the United States, and I would and obviously with that you let some people in, but you don't let a million in a year. And secondly, with regard to people coming from countries with large Muslim populations, where people are at war with one another, committing terrible atrocities, I mean, you would not bring people in from these war zones.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. You know what John Kerry said yesterday, according to the State Department notes. We're putting that up on the screen right now. This is one of the most outrageous things I've ever heard said. Just thinking it is insane. But to say it, and for a Secretary of State to say it, but to me, it's exactly what Obama thinks, and it's exactly what John Kerry believes and others on the left. He said there's something different about what happened from Charlie Hebdo, and I think everybody would feel that. There was a sort of particularized focus and perhaps even a legitimacy in terms of, then he said, not legitimacy, but a rationale that you could attach yourself to somehow and say, okay, they're really angry because of this and that. This Friday was absolutely indiscriminate. Are we now picking legitimate terror attacks versus illegitimate terror attacks?
Look, I'm not a fan of Charlie Hebdo and their cartoons, but that does not justify mass murder, which is what happened with Charlie Hebdo. My guess is that John Kerry is terribly tired, and what he meant to say probably was that Charlie Hebdo, they picked that because Charlie Hebdo had insulted the Prophet, and it might help them in the crazed part of the Islamic world to do it, whereas this massacre was of anybody who happened to be in that stadium or happened to be at that concert or happened to be at that restaurant. But I think, I mean, John Kerry is very tired, and there is nothing legitimate about mass murder or terrorism against innocent civilians. I don't care whether they write nasty cartoons or not.
Yeah, well, absolutely. So he's tired. He needs a nap.
No, I do think, I mean, both he and the President of the United States appear to be out of sorts and really not focused. And what is the president out there in with the Paris thing going on, attacking Republicans and attacking candidates and, you know, attacking people because they want to put a hold on immigration from the Muslim world? I mean, many of the proposals out there make real common sense
absolutely
to most Americans. The president ought to wait till he gets home to address them.
Absolutely. Pat, always great to talk to you, sir. Thank you very much. By the way, read Pat Buchanan at newsmax.com/insiders. And we'll speak to you soon, Pat.
Take it easy.
You too. All right, folks, up next, Emmy Award-winning journalist Cheryl Atkinson will weigh in. You're not going to want to miss this, I promise.